2011 president of the American Chemical Society, Nancy Jackson, comes from a family of strong women who valued education.
I was brought up believing that education was very important, and both my grandmothers had master's degrees, which was very unusual. They both got them in the 1920s, so there was a lot of expectation of the women in my family that we would become educated and be involved in the world.
She grew up in Wisconsin, where her parents were devoted to public service. Her Seneca father, a minister, held various jobs in the church hierarchy, and her Caucasian mother eventually became a minister herself when Jackson was 30 years old. Jackson suspects that this influenced her strong initial interest in politics. She worked for several public officials before going to George Washington University as a political science major. Mentors made all the difference in Jackson's transition to a career in science.
When I was a teenager, I had a great passion for politics. And so I ended up going to college to major in political science. But I took chemistry as my science class in college, and I thought it was kind of interesting when I was in high school, but I didn't really learn that much from that class. I wanted to learn more. And I ended up with an A in chemistry and a B in political science. And so my chemistry professor, my freshman chemistry professor, started talking to me about chemistry and what I could do. And I think the thing that finally convinced me was, besides the fact that I just enjoyed it, it was also because he said that I could probably make a greater impact on policy as a scientist than I could if I just majored in political science. And I think he was right.
Taking lab classes also convinced Jackson that chemistry was the right choice for her.
I loved the labs. I loved working in the labs. I loved the qualitative analysis class we took. And everything was a different color, and you would add this, and it would turn this color, and you could measure it. And I just thought it was in the laboratory, making things change and making things happen, that I just really loved most of all.
But a pre-calculus class halted Jackson in her tracks and shook her confidence so much that she dropped out of school for a few months. When she returned, she took that math class again, did well, and officially changed her major to chemistry. After earning her bachelor's degree, Jackson wasn't sure what to do next. She answered a job ad for a position in the American Chemical Society's education department. While working at ACS headquarters in Washington, D.C., she met a scientist who really made an impression and became another mentor. That person was Harry Gray from the California Institute of Technology.
But Harry Gray is a very dynamic individual. His ability to believe in his students and his charismatic personality and the way he just loved chemistry and students had an influence on his ability to do chemistry. I could see that he attracted smart people to work for him, and so he really had an influence on my going to graduate school and knowing that I would probably be very happy as a PhD scientist.
Jackson went back to school at the University of Texas, Austin, earning her PhD in chemical engineering in 1990. She then joined the Sandia National Laboratories in Albuquerque, New Mexico, as a research chemist. Today, she's the manager of the International Chemical Threat Reduction Department at Sandia. There, she helps the U.S. Department of State and other federal agencies solve problems related to international chemical security. Jackson's job combines her love of science and policy and has allowed her to raise awareness of chemical safety and security. Jackson has also encouraged young scientists from minority backgrounds by serving as a mentor and by being involved in several ACS committees, such as the Younger Chemists Committee and the Committee on Minority Affairs. Jackson still believes that chemistry is the ideal way to have an impact on society and the world during the International Year of Chemistry in 2011 and beyond.
Well, I think that chemistry is a great basis for doing many things. I think you can do anything with chemistry, and I think that it's very important that we have lots of people who are dedicated towards addressing the issues in the developing world, and we need a lot of scientists and engineers to do that, and I think it's just an enormously important way that young people can contribute to their country.